Welcome to the final part of the Headlock series from bottom side control. Well, final part so far. There's still a top part that I'm gonna make and other things, but let's start with this again. The final layer, come here. I talked about rolling over, rolling backwards, walking in, walking around. I talked about leg control. I didn't talk about the arm yet. So I went out from the premise that I got either this hand or catch my leg, great. Now what can happen? Maybe sometimes you don't even have control at all, right? And what if I always go from the active side first. I roll you over. Give me your hand. Really grab me with both hands, please. Mm-hmm. So maybe Latif got this hold. If I start to roll him over, see? Well, either will follow or post his hand on the floor. He posts his hand and I keep insisting. This is very important. Look, a very big beginner mistake is this. You roll and people post and they assume it doesn't work. Then they switch to the other side. But all I did was just give him his hand back. So this is one of the very big principles that I use. Every time someone posts something, you have to give a reason to that post. So stretch your, so put your arm on the floor and I rotate in. Now he has to carry all my weight and his weight and my rotation on this hand. Now this will get tired and it will crumble or it will push back. The moment he pushes, just push yourself away, please. The moment he pushes away, he stretches his arm. So now make it more obvious, stretch it, please. Here, when he stretches, I'm gonna make a reverse grip. So now this, I'm gonna put my thumb outside and catch his hand. And I'm gonna push myself away. Now, if I just stay here, I want to control Latif's hand, not his shoulder, not his elbow. So now Latif, just chaotically move your arm, please. I cannot really work with it, and I'm gonna move, lose control. I'm gonna put an extra point of control. That's my knee on his elbow. Stretch your arm completely, please. Again, it will not be a finish, but just for your beginners and to get a feeling, try to get a feeling of having an arm lock here. Imagine this would work. Okay, so you put your hand up, put your knee on the elbow, put pressure down. So put the hand, push the hand up first, put pressure down, and there we have it up. Will this work? Most likely not. But it triggers something. Look, at its control, and now Latif is forced to do something. The easiest one is he starts to, so I really insist on the arm lock, which will never work, and he bends his arm. As he goes, I step over his arm over here. Okay, now F and Americana, almost. Now, two things Latif can do. He can stay, three things. So he can stay, he can walk backside, or he can walk headside. If he walks backside, he actually Americanas himself. You feel right?
Yeah.
Okay, great. But in theory, if he goes that side, what I gotta do is keep the head, walk that side, please. He walks that side, I'm looking away, and I extend my hip. Easy. Now, easier gets if Latif starts to walk towards my head over here. It actually alleviates the pressure on his arm, correct, right?
Yeah.
Okay, go back. That's just the way the Americana works. So if I'm putting pressure here and he starts to walk over my head, I'm gonna make the scoop again. And I still have it. Now, if I do this motion, see, now if Latif walks back, it will alleviate again. And then I have to go to the baby bridge again. And this works in both ways. So once again, I push, I roll over. He pushes the floor, push himself backwards. As he pushes, push yourself away. I catch the arm, put pressure on my knee. Now this time Latif got smarter, he rotates arm the other side.
The other side, yeah.
So what's the opposite of an Americano? It's Kimura, he bends his arm, and I'm gonna catch his arm now with my hand over here. Now I'm gonna be honest, the Kimura is a bit harder to finish, because he can always spin out of that. But in any case, he can use that spin. So look, I'm gonna act like this is Kimura. It's a bit like a reverse omoplata, to be honest. I'm gonna put my foot up and put my knee to the floor. Now again, Latif can do three things. Stay, walk in, walk out. If Latif walks this way, see, what I'm gonna do is gonna move in. I'm gonna make a scoop. So walk, Latif. See, insist. Hard, right?
Yeah.
Very good. Yeah. So in this case, again, slowly start lifting his hand up. There is a tap. Now will this tap ever happen? No. Because the moment I start lifting, Latif can start walking to the other side. And that alleviates the pain, right?
Yeah.
But in this case, keep walking, see? I can get up on my elbow and start rolling him over here. Now will this finish work? Again, no, because Latif can keep rolling, but what mechanics do I use? I step again, get underneath, and I roll over. And now I get on top, see? And this is actually a position where I can do the finish, see? So, I can stay here, see? And what ideally, if Latif comes up a little bit, it makes it, I just ask this because it's less pain for him, see? If I scoop my butt out, now I have the Kimura over here on this side. So once again, from this angle, come here, Latif. So I go up, or maybe even down. Latif was here, I roll, push your hand on the floor, push yourself away, boom. So really push yourself, this is gonna be harder. If you do this, what you're doing now, mm-hmm. you're pushing yourself up, push up, mm-hmm. then I'm gonna use this to get in over here. Mm-hmm. I really ask you now to push yourself towards your heels. Push yourself away. Great, yeah, catch. Push away. Push my knee on the elbow. And go for intents and purposes, I go for an arm bar. Just easy to control, difficult to control. I rotate his thumb up. Yeah, I keep insisting, he'll bend his arm more. Step over, catch. Keep control of that squeeze. Either he walks foot side, okay, I'm gonna look away, baby reach. He walks head side, I make the scoop and Americana again. Other variation, I push down, he bends his arm, I bring it up, catch it in my hand, he brings the elbow up. From here, depends where he walks again. Walk this side, okay, I'm gonna look in and bring his arm up. And if I want to add more pressure on this, I'm gonna really like bridge. And it's a tap, maybe not, but 5 pieces of it. He's gonna push. If I'm here, he will push forward at some point to alleviate the pain. And this is the active one, or the one actually I'm gonna get. See, go up here. Walk a bit backwards, please. Yeah. So from here, I keep looking away, rotate over my shoulder. See, nose on the floor. Go over, fall down, switch my hip, and I can finish him on this side. And even if he gets his hand out, which can happen, you are on top, or even on bottom if he escapes, then, which obviously happens, is sometimes they are faster. See, he can push, he escapes his arm. What I often do even is get my arm out, see, and go for a control like this. See, he tried to fight here. You do the same things. See, I walk away, I drive his shoulder to the floor, lift his hand up, which will trigger him to walk over my head, see, start going, and then you go underneath. I can fight again. This concludes the headlock series from bottom side control. And now the magic thing is this, top and bottom is just the same. It means earth has rotated around, gravity is opposite in this case, but everything that works on bottom works on top and vice versa. After this, I'm gonna take a little bit of a break from this position and then we visit it again and we go over some details from top headlock or scarf hold. I hope you like the series. Please let me know what you think about it in the comments. Send to your friends, because I really think it's like an underdeveloped and underexplored part of the game. You can watch the whole series here. It'll be forever online. You can keep rewatching it and or watch any of my other videos on this site.